circular motion, angular velocity. If an object is moving in a circular motion, and I draw the radius here from center to circumference, the object is traveling from A to B, it will subtend an angle theta and an arc length from A to B of S with a radius R and R. And the object has a relationship between the arc length A to B and radius and theta, where we say that R is S over theta, and therefore S equals R theta. A few things to iron out is that we know that the angular displacement, because the name says angle displacement, so you can go from A to B, is going to be theta. And we know what theta is. Theta is S over R. That's the angular displacement. The linear displacement is going to be S, and S is the arc length. You know, this is minor sector and that's the major sector. This is the arc, minor arc. From A to B is minor arc, and A the other way around is major arc. So now we now know the formulas for angular displacement. But what we want to know is angular velocity. Angular velocity will be angular velocity will be the angular displacement over time. Likewise, linear velocity will be equal to linear displacement over time. The angular displacement is theta, so that'll be theta over t, and the linear displacement would be S, go from A to B, S over t. So the linear velocity is S over t, and the angular velocity is theta over t. Angular velocity has a symbol omega. That's not W, but omega. Omega is a Greek letter. So that equals omega. And that equals V for velocity. So now what we now need to do is to write down the relationship between the two of them. S equals R theta, and the linear velocity V is equal to S over T, and if we replace S with R theta, it's going to be R theta over T. And if we can R times theta over t, and that would be R. Theta over t is omega, that would be omega. So therefore, V equals R omega. So that's the second important equation. apart from that equation, which is very important. That is also important. But this is a third important equation. Right. So we can see that a linear velocity is equal to radius times angular velocity. Don't forget that the unit for angular velocity is going to be, the unit will be rad, because it's in radians, over seconds. So that's the unit for angular velocity. Unit for linear velocity would be meters per second. So that would just be meters over seconds. So writing down the unit for angular velocity, it's in radians, rad, per seconds. And linear velocity, it's in meters per second.